Okay, on the first class today of the chapter matrix for class 10 AC examination, we'll be talking about the determinant of matrix, and we'll also be talking about the inverse of matrix, and we'll talk about the non-singular matrix as well. And see, first of all, a definition has been written there for the determinant of matrix. So if you have a matrix A, like A, B, C, D, that is a 2x2 matrix, it means that, we have a matrix A here, it's a 2x2 matrix, it means there are two rows and two columns here. So this is a matrix where these elements are A, B, C, and D. Now, to find the determinant of this matrix, what we'll do is, we'll first multiply the main diagonal, that is A into D. And we subtract the product of all the two diagonals from the main diagonals to get the determinant of matrix. It means that first we multiply A into D and then subtract, and then we multiply B into C. Suppose if you have A equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose we have this matrix. Now if you are told to find the determinant of matrix, this is how we write the determinant of matrix. We write a column, like we'll draw a line here this way, and this is how we supposed to write the determinant of matrix. Equals to, again the same column, same straight line, like 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we multiply this thing, main diagram first. 1 into 4 minus 3 into 2. 1 into 4 is 4, 3 into 2 is 6, 4 minus 2 is minus 2. This real number, minus 2, is the determinant of matrix A. It's very simple, just multiply these two, subtract, multiply the second two, 3 into 2. This is how we find the determinant of matrix. Now, I hope that you all are clear. Look at one more example here. Suppose we have a matrix like sine, cos, minus cos theta, and sine theta. Suppose we have this matrix. Now, to get the determinant of matrix A, sine theta, cos theta, minus cos theta, sine theta. First, we multiply the principal diagonal or the main diagonal. Sine theta into sine theta will give you sine square theta, minus. Cos theta into minus cos theta will give you minus cos square theta. So, this will be like sine square theta, minus into minus becomes plus, cos square theta, sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. This is how we solve, this is the determinant of matrix there. Now, we'll talk about the inverse of matrix. Okay, now I'm going to talk about inverse of matrix. See, suppose you have two matrices A and B, and of the same order. They are the A and B are two matrices, two square matrices of same order. If that happens, then the product of A and B, if the product of A and B gives you an identity matrix. Identity matrix means like 1, 0, 0, 1. Then the matrix A and B are called inverse matrix. A and B are the inverse matrix. So the condition for to be A and B are inverse matrix is, first, they need to be a square matrix. Second, the product of A and B should give an identity matrix. If that happens, then this matrix A and the matrix B can be told as an inverse matrix. So we can define inverse matrix in the way that if A and B are two square matrices of same order, has been told already also, if A and B are two matrices of same order and I is an identity matrix of the same order, I also should be the identity matrix of the same order, then AB into BA equal to I. So now, if this happens, A and B are two square matrices of the same order, I is an identity matrix of the same order. Okay, now then, if AB is equal to BA equals to I, then we can say that AB and BA are inverse to each other. So this is the another thing we learned today, inverse matrix. So one thing to know about inverse matrix is that when two matrices of same order are multiplied, and if the result is an identity matrix of the same order, then the matrix A and matrix B, or those two matrices, can be called as inverse matrix. Now, the third thing we'll learn today is singular matrix. This is more focus for examination. Singular matrix, if you talk about the singular matrix, then
a square matrix A can be called a single row matrix if the determinant of A is 0.
It means that कुनै पनि म्याट्रिक्सको डिटर्मिनेन्ट जिरो आउँछ भने त्यसलाई सिङ्गल म्याट्रिक्स भनिन्छ. आई रिपिट वान मोर टाइम, इफ एनी अफ द म्याट्रिसेस ह्याभ अ डिटर्मिनेन्ट जिरो देन द्याट काइन्ड अफ म्याट्रिक्स इज कल्ड सिङ्गल म्याट्रिक्स. सो इफ ए इज द स्क्वायर म्याट्रिक्स देन एन्ड इफ द डिटर्मिनेन्ट अफ ए इज जिरो देन ए क्यान बी कल्ड एज अ सिङ्गल म्याट्रिक्स. एन्ड फर एभ्री अदर म्याट्रिसेस हुज इलिमेन्ट्स आर नट जिरो, सरी हुज डिटर्मिनेन्ट्स आर नट जिरो, एभ्री अदर म्याट्रिसेस हुज डिटर्मिनेन्ट आर नट जिरो, those other matrices can be called as non-singular matrix. As I'm inverse of matrix for the cost k inverse of matrix when I go jab duita matrix la multiply garda identity matrix auncha bhane to duita matrix lai chha hami inverse matrix bhancha. अनि सिङ्गुलर म्याट्रिक्स भनेको कुनै पनि म्याट्रिक्सको डिटर्मिनेन्ट यदि जिरो आउँछ भने त्यो सिङ्गुलर म्याट्रिक्स भयो, यदि जिरो आउँदैन भने त्यो नन सिङ्गुलर म्याट्रिक्स भयो. अनि सुरुमा हामीले पढेको डिटर्मिनेन्ट निकाल्न, डिटर्मिनेन्ट निकाल्न के गर्नु पर्दो रहेछ, सपोज 1, 2, 3, 4 छ भने चाहिँ यो मेन डायगोनल मल्टिप्लाई गर्ने, सब्ट्र्याक्ट गर्ने, माथिको दुईटा डायगोनल्सको इलिमेन्टहरूलाई पनि मल्टिप्लाई गर्ने, त्यो भयो अर्को कुरो. Okay, here you have been given a matrix and you have to find the determinant of a square plus 5a minus 49. Okay, here a is 3, 5, 1, 2. Now I am finding a square. A square is a into a. Okay, it is like 3, 5, 1, 2 multiplying to 3, 5, 1, 2. Now, this video is made with the procession that you have some knowledge regarding the multiplication of matrices. So, now multiply 3 into 3. First 3 into 3, 9, plus 5 into 1, 5. Again, 3 into 5, 15, plus 5 into 2, 10. 1 into 3, 3. 2 into 1, 2. 1 into 5, 5. 3 into 2, 4. So, it will be like 14, 25, 5, 9. Okay, we got a square. Now we have to find the value of this part. A square plus 5a minus 14i. See, what is your a square? We already have a square. 14, 25, 5, 9. 5. 5 multiplies to a. We have matrix A. 3, 5, 1, 2. 3, 5, 1, 2 minus 14. I cannot access it here. Okay, one more time. A square 14, 25, 5, 9 plus 5, 8. 3, 5, 1, 2 minus 14. I is 1001. Now let us multiply this. 14, 25, 5, 9. Now we can multiply this. 5 into 3 is 15. 5 into 5 is 25. 5 into 5 is 5. 5 into 2 is 10. Now similarly, 41 is 14. 0, 0, 14. Now let us solve it. 14 plus 15 minus 14. Similarly, 25 plus 25 minus 0. Likewise, 5 plus 5 minus 0. And then 9 plus 10 minus 14. We all know to do this one. 14 plus, okay, simple. Now you can cancel it. You have here 15. 25 into 25 is 25 plus 25 is 50. 5 plus 5 is 10. And 9 plus 10 is 19, 19 minus 14 is 5. Now solve it. Now, so this is a square minus 5a minus 49. What do we have to find our determinant of this part? Now, I am drawing this portion. We have to find the determinant of. Now, we have to find the determinant. So we give a symbol of determinant. A square plus 5a minus 14i. Equals to 50 50 10 5. Now multiply 15 into 5. Alright, okay, now for the first time 15 into 5 minus 10 into 15. 15 into 5 is 75, 10 into 50 is 500. And the answer comes to be minus 425.
This is how we find the determinant of the matrix. Okay, here the matrix A has been given and the determinant of matrix A is also given, and you have to find the value of x here. See,
here A equals to 2x641. Now determinant of A, now how do you find the determinant of A? It is given in one case, or 2x641 equal to 4. It has been given by the question. This is provided by the question. Now multiply 2x into 1, 2x minus 4 into 6 is 24 equals to 4. So it's very simple. 2x into 1 is 2x minus current. Determinant got that. And minus current is or co elements are multiplied. 2x. Okay. Now 4 minus 24 goes back and becomes plus 24. Or 2x equals to 28, and the value of x comes to be 40. This is how you solve the problem.
Okay, in this question you have been given the matrix A, and you have to show that matrix A is a singular matrix. First you have to understand what a singular matrix is. As it was told earlier, singular matrix are those matrices whose determinant is zero. It means that you have to show that the matrix A has determinant 0. If you can show that matrix A has the determinant 0, then you can tell that it is a singular matrix. And on the second sentence, you have been told to write some answer of the question. The question is that at what condition the matrix cannot be defined. So you have to tell under what condition the matrix cannot be defined. Let me tell you right now. I'm not writing it on the board. Matrix cannot be defined if its determinant is 0. I repeat one more time, matrix cannot be defined if its determinant is 0. Or you can simply tell the matrix cannot be defined if it is a singular matrix or does not have its inverse. It is the same thing. A matrix doesn't have the inverse if its determinant is 0, or matrix doesn't have its inverse if it is a singular matrix. So these are the answer for the theory question that was asked later. Let me show you the first one.
Here A equals to 2, 6, 4, 12. This is matrix A. I'm finding the determinant of A. Determinant of A is 2, 6, 4, 12. We'll measure it this way. Come on, by 2 into 12 minus 4 into 6. 2 into 12 is 24, 4 into 6 is also 24. 24 minus 24 is 0. Now you have to write here, since determinant of matrix A is 0, it is a singular matrix. Alright, and I have told you the answer for the things that was written later. At what condition the matrix cannot be defined? The matrix cannot be defined if its determinant is 0 or if it is a singular matrix. The same thing for the next question also. At what condition a matrix doesn't have its inverse? The matrix doesn't have its inverse if its determinant is 0 or if it is a singular matrix. So this matrix A cannot be defined. This matrix A does not have its inverse also. Thank you. Okay, in this question, you have been told that the line x plus y equal to 5 cuts a circle x square plus y square equal to 13. You have to find the distance between the two points. Now I'm explaining the question. This is the line x plus y equal to 5. Suppose that this is the line whose equation. Suppose this is x plus y equal to 5 is a line, and it's okay. This is a line, fine. X plus y equal to 5 is a straight line, and this is a circle. And the equation of the circle is x square plus y square equals to 13. This is a line, and this is a circle. Now you can observe that the circle whose equation is x square plus y square equals to 13 has been cut by a line x plus y equals to 5 at two points. You can see. This is one point, this is the another point. You circle, sir. Your circle equation, whose equation is x square plus y square equal to 13. To circle lie, or a line, x plus y equal to 5, lay, do it how kateko, sir. Do it how choeko, sir. Do it how toss girl, sir. Intersect girl, sir. A and B. Now you have to find the distance of these two points, of this point and this point.
So before you find the distance of these two points, what you have to find it first is the coordinates of this point. You have to find the coordinates of the point A, you have to find the coordinates of the point B, and then by using distance law, you have to find it. Now I'm solving it. See, here,
given equation of straight line, given equation of line is x plus y equals to 5, which is opposite equation 1, and equation of circle. And the equation of circle is x square plus y square equals to 30. This is equation 2.
Now when we solve these two equations, then we get the value of x and we get the value of y. And this value of x and y are the intersecting point. Now we solve it. Now solve equation 1 and 2.
Okay, now from equation 1. Equation 1 is x plus y equals to 5. So x equals to 5 minus y, putting x equals to 5 minus y in equation 2. To equation 2 is x square plus y square equals to 13, or in place of x you are going to write here 5 minus y square plus y square equals to 13, or 5 square is 25, 5 plus 10y plus y square plus y square equals to 13.
Now,
or y square plus y square is 2y square minus 10y, 25 minus 13 is 8, plus 8 equals to 0. Now 8 is 16, and now we are solving it. We all know how to solve it. 2 plus 8. Y plus 8 equals to 0, or 2y square minus 2y minus 8y plus 8 equals to 0. I'm coming here, or now from this 2y square and 2y, I'm taking 2y common. Now after taking 2y common, you have 2y minus 1, and from 8y 8 you get 8 common.
Okay, fine. So I got a mistake here.
I was wondering why it is not being solved. It is not 8 here, it will be like 12 here. Now see, we can write here 12. Now you can take 2 common from all the terms. 2 common, y square minus 5y plus 6 equals to 0. Now when if 2 goes back there, it becomes cancelled. Now you have your y square minus 5y plus 6 equals to 0. Now on solving it, you have your 2 plus 3y plus 6 equals to 0, or y square minus 2y minus into process minus 3y plus 6 equals to 0. Or now when you take y common, you have your y minus 2, 3 common here, y minus 3 equals to 0, or y minus 2, y minus 3 equal to 0. So therefore, either y minus 3 equal to 0, so the value of y becomes to be 2. Similarly, y minus 3 equal to 0, so the value of y becomes 3.
Now we got the values of y. Now we need the value of x. Now, I'm robbing the board, the upper part, upper portion. Now we need the value of x.
Now see, from here, I'm coming here, when y equals to 2, we get x equals to, we have x equals to 5 minus y. In place of this y, we're going to write here 2. So 5 minus 2 equal to 3. So when y equals to 3, now y equals to 2, 7, 2, 7, 3, 7. Y equals to 2, the x equals to 1, so y equals to 3, the x equals to 1, fine, we'll get that. Now we get x equals to 5 minus, the place value of y is 3, 3 equals to 2. Therefore, the line plots circle at, the line is circle at, 3, 2, x equals to 3, the y equals to 2, अर्को 2,3 मा छ 2,3 एक्स त अगाडि लेख्ने वाई लाई पछाडि लेख्ने न हामीले यसको डिस्टेन्स निकाल्नु भने त फाइन्ड द डिस्टेन्स बिटवीन द टु पॉइंट्स दिस टु पॉइंट्स नाउ यूजिंग डिस्टेन्स फर्मुला Now you can use distance formula to find the answer. So I'm using the distance formula 3 minus 2 1 square plus 3 minus 2 1 square. So it will be like root under 2 units. This is the distance between these points.
Thank you so much. कल कहीं distance निकालना ना ला रहा क्या पनी गौर से अन्य टीम ले यो दुईटा कट गरेको पॉइंट सँग इक्वल हुने डायमीटर को इक्वेसन निकाल्न आउँछ त्यतिखेर चाहिँ हामीले यो दुईटा पॉइंट चाहिँ इन पॉइंट्स अफ डायमीटर मान्नु पर्छ अनि इक्वेसन अफ सर्कल निकाल्न पर्छ को जस्तै ओके नाउ वी आर फाइन्डिङ द इन्भर्स अफ म्याट्रिक्स ए इन्भर्स अफ म्याट्रिक्स ए निकाल्नु लागेको छ यसको मिनिङ व्हाट वी आर टोल्ड टु फाइन्ड इज वी आर टोल्ड टु फाइन्ड अनदर म्याट्रिक्स जसको डिटर्मिनेन्ट सरी जसको जसले यो म्याट्रिक्सलाई मल्टिप्लाई गर्यो भने चाहिँ आइडेन्टिटी म्याट्रिक्स आउँछ हामी म्याट्रिक्स ए दिएको छ म्याट्रिक्स एसँग मल्टिप्लाई गर म्याट्रिक्स एलाई मल्टिप्लाई गरेर आइडेन्टिटी म्याट्रिक्स निकाल्ने अर्को म्याट्रिक्स चाहिँ कुन हो भनेर फाइन्ड गर्दैछौँ हामी नाउ सी नाउ फर्स्ट निकाल्नको लागि फर्स्ट वी फाइन्ड द डिटर्मिनेन्ट अफ दिस म्याट्रिक्स ए नाउ वी हेभ अ फर्मुला द फर्मुला इज ए इन्भर्स मिन्स म्याट्रिक्स एको इन्भर्स निकाल्नको लागि वी हेभ फर्मुला 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Now I'll be talking about the adjoint of A at the same time. 1 by determinant of A is minus 1. Adjoint of A money go. A ko adjoint money go. Now see. Yosko sigma, your principal diagonal scope place like change garment. Change the place. 2 ko dhamma ke lekhne. Minus 5 lekhne. Yo minus 5 lekhne. And yo minus 5 ko dhamma ke lekhne. 2 lekhne. See. First step is to change the place of identity, principal diagram. Interchange the place of principal diagram. Minus 5 was here, we got it here. 2 was here, we got it down. First step to change the place. Now, second step is to change the sign of the remaining elements. Change the sign of the remaining elements is these and these elements are left, your rock elements are. Now, the sign of 3 here is plus. Now, we make it minus. And the sign of 3 here is minus. So, we make it plus. First of all, change the place and then change the sign. Now, 1 by minus 1 is, minus 1 is up to 1 plus. We get here, 1 by minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1, okay, minus 1, minus 5, minus 3, 3, 2. Now, multiply. Minus 1 into minus 5 is 5, minus 1 into minus 3 is 3, minus 1 into 3 is minus 3, minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. So, this is A inverse. If you multiply these two matrix, you'll get an identity matrix. So this is the step. These are the procedure for finding the inverse of matrix. See, I'm talking about one more time about adjoint of this matrix A. So Mathi, Surma, isko camera is not capturing everything at the same time. That's why I'm having a little problem. So I was talking about finding the inverse of the matrix. It means adjoint of the matrix. See, this is matrix A. First of all, change the place. Minus 5, this comes here, this goes here. Minus 5 into. Baaki aapke element ko k change karne, sign change karne. And in here, 1 by minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 is sabse pehle hum karne, aur answer nikalne. So this is A inverse. So if you check that A and A inverse, then it will give an identity matrix. In this question, you have been given two matrices and you have been told that these two matrices are inverse to each other and you have been told to find the value of x. I'm solving the problem in two different ways. First way,
I'm talking about the first method. First method is find the inverse of this matrix. First method is to inverse the value of x. Just like in the previous way. A equals to 4, 2, 5, 3. Now find the determinant of A. 4 into 3 minus 5 into 2. 4 to the 2 by 2 is 10. 2 by minus 10 is 2. Okay, 2 minus 10 is 2. Now A inverse equals to your formula is 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Or 1 by the determinant A is 2. Now we are finding the adjoint of A. First of all, change their place. In place of 4, write here 3. In place of 3, write here 4. And now change the sign. plus 2 changes to minus 2, plus 5 changes to minus 5. Now 1 by 2 into 3 is 3 by 2, 1 by 2 into minus 2 is minus 1, 1 by 2 into minus 5 is minus 5 by 2, 1 by 2 into 4 is 2. We got it.
Now we just multiply this. Now your question, now see the question, this is the inverse of matrix A. A inverse, A inverse, here. And question also have given you the inverse of matrix A. It means that these two inverse, the inverse that we have obtained here and the inverse that exists here, they both are equal. See, by question, question has told that these two matrices are inverse. First of all, we found the inverse of the given matrix. Now we are going to equate this with this matrix. Now on equating,
now I'm equating this thing. First you have this one, x minus 1 minus 5 by 2, 2 equals to, you have here 3 by 2 minus 1 minus 5 by 2 and 2.
So we have equated these two matrices. Why can we equate these two matrices? Because both are the inverse of the matrix A. See, this is the answer we obtained by calculating, and this is the question given by this is the matrix given by the question. Now on equating, we get
x equals to 3 by 2. This is one of the way to solve the algebra problem. The next way is, this is the first method. Now the next method is, question has given that these two matrices are inverse to each other. Question said that these are inverse to each other. So if these two matrices are inverse to each other, then of course that their product will give an identity matrix. So here 4, 2, 5, 3 and x minus 1 minus 5 by 2, 2 are inverse matrix to each other. So their product will give an identity matrix. So 4, 2, 5, 3. Either inverse matrix, so inverse matrix one. If you think it's matrix one, identity matrix one. So one. They were S by the U matrix, I multiply by one. Identity matrix one. Now, let's multiply it. 4 into x is 4x. 2 into minus 5 by 2 is minus 5. 4 into minus 1 is minus 4. 3 into 2 is 4. 5 into x is 5x. 3 into minus 5 by 2 is minus 15 by 2. 5 into minus 1 is minus 5. 3 into 2 is 6. Equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. Now we will equate the corresponding element. Now equating the corresponding element, you have 4x minus 5 equals to 1. 4x minus 5 equals to 1. Or 4x equals to 6. So x equals to 6 by 4, that comes to be 3 by 2. We have to find all the possible values of x. So whenever you find x, just solve it. You also have 5x minus 15 by 2 equals to 0. 5x minus 15 by 2 equals to 0. Or 5x equals to 15 by 2. Or x equals to 15 by 2 into 5. Your 5 is on the upper. 5 is the 15. So the value of x will be 3 by 2. So the required value of x is 3 by 2. So this much for today.